Well, howdy, 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 folks. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I want to talk to you about vending illegally. Like, could you vend illegally? Well, according to thousands of people, you can. According to the news and stuff out in California, a lot of people vend illegally. And they've even changed the laws to make them do less stuff because what they had done is they had created rules and codes in California that made it hindered vending so bad as far as to only the best and the richest people, the people with the most money. They made it so bad that they vended illegally. So they've created some new rules that allow them to get into the business easier, and that's all just come about in the last say 6 8 months. But there are people that go out and vend without a permit, without a license. I hate to say illegally because that sounds like, oh my gosh, he robbed a bank. You mean he was serving food without a permit? He hadn't paid y'all yet? How dare he? But there's some wise information behind it. You know, they want to make sure that the person that's vending has is following food codes for food safety to protect the public from some rogue guy grabbing rats out of the sewer and, you know, or the subway and tunnels and serving them up. Well, that's what they try to prevent by having training and inspections and stuff like that. But what California was doing alternatively was putting some astronomical fees to just get started. You could start a Cracker Barrel restaurant, you know, with a $75 license, but for hot dog vending, 960. How dare you try to do that? So it's one of those things that I wouldn't want to do it, but I would tell you this. I can't recommend doing it, but I can tell you this. I would do it in a New York second if I needed to feed my family and it was a means to an end. Okay, because I instead of going and robbing banks or stealing people's stuff, I'm not stealing anything. I'm still paying my taxes, still doing all the stuff I'm supposed to do, except for I didn't pay for the permit. I would do it. I wouldn't recommend that. There's other ways. There's the beg, borrow, and I say steal, but not steal, but beg, borrow, and sell everything you can to raise the funds so you can start at least on a shoestring. A lot of states now have the Cottage Industry Act, which has allowed you to do all kinds of stuff from your home without a big license. In some states, no license because it's an agriculture product. So, or typically is agriculture products. If you want to know more about that, you can go to learnhotdogs.com/broke. Okay. It's like starting without any money, but if I had to, I would. There's a lady that, and I've told this before to you. There's a lady that was in Nashville, Tennessee, that didn't speak a lick of English and didn't have a way to get a license because she was vending. She was here in the States illegally, right? Well, she bought a cart. They give you a driver's license. I mean, she has a driver's license and was paying taxes, okay? But she couldn't get her permit to vend because she was an illegal. Now she could go get a DMV license and a tag for a car and a car in her name, but she couldn't have any of the other stuff. So she vended at night. And within a few months, she bought a second cart from me. And then a few months later, a third cart from me. And I don't know how many carts she ended up with, but she ended up moving, I believe, to New Mexico. Or maybe she stayed there and her daughter moved to New Mexico. I don't remember. But the bottom line is it was a means to an end. It was a means till she could get made legal so that she could do her stuff. If you had to, you have to. But if you don't have to, I try to avoid any red flags or any, I try to avoid anything that would cause me problems in the future. So I wouldn't do it unless I just absolutely had to. But now with the cottage law acts and stuff, it's able to do stuff without any problem. We had a lady that couldn't do the cottage industry. She was in a state that didn't even have the Cottage Industry Act. Okay. And I wrote about her, and I'm gonna tell you where that link is too. Learnhotdogs.com/donut, /donut. And if you go there, you'll see that that lady is started in a motel room that she was renting by the day or by the week or whatever. And she started selling donuts. Not that she was making them. She was 100% legal what she was doing. Legal. So there's so many alternatives now without having to do something illegal or cause yourself any problems. Now, do they come and arrest you and handcuff you? I've only seen that once. Or I say I've only seen that in one state, and that was California. Now California's updated their code, so I don't know that that would happen there. New York, I have heard about some people getting some hefty fines, but in other states, I've heard about them going, "Hey, you can't be out here without a license. You need to get a license. Let me give you the number." And so it could be as minimal as, you know, a $50 fine or a slap on the, you know, the hand, or it can mean that you have to, you know, you lose your cart, like they've impounded or something crazy, or impound your equipment that you're using. So I would say steer clear from it. Now that you know that there's so many other things to do, right down below in this video, right in the section that says the description, I'm going to put you a bunch of links to ways other people that have written in or called in or talked to me or let me video them, like the donut lady, that let me share their story. And I'm going to share those stories with you in those links. And feel free to jump in there and go, you know what, that would work for me. Or I could do boiled peanuts. You know, some states boil peanuts, no license, no nothing. Okay. So there's so many alternatives to get into the business. And it may not be, I hate boiled peanuts, I ain't doing boiled peanuts. If it's a means to an end, it beats going out illegally or without licensing. Okay. So if it gets you to from A to B so that you can go ahead and fulfill your dream, then do it. By all means, do it. That's all I got to say. I love you. And I'll talk to you later. Bye.
Have you ever wondered why the guy selling hot dogs always seems so happy?
Hello, Mrs. Smith. Hello, Mr. Johnson. Could I interest either of you in a hot dog?
Do you want to find out why?
LearnHotDogs.com. Get free video training, earn points, and get free stuff. Read Ben's hot dog blog and more. The premier source for hot dog vending information. Go to LearnHotDogs.com. Working like a dog.